Lester Holt is with you tomorrow. I'm Kate Snow. For all of us here, stay safe. Have a great night.
Just behind me, hundreds, if not 1,000 migrants waiting under the blazing sun.
All these people here are going to be asking for asylum.
It's a very critical situation.
You love a cold, refreshing soft drink from McDonald's. So we've got even colder ones.
Sip into summer with the chillest drinks, like the new frozen Hawaiian Punch or your favorite frappe or smoothie. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Wish you had help getting things done.
Same.
So I got section one.
Fast internet, unlimited mobile, and advanced Wi-Fi, all for a great price. Spectrum helps me run all this easily. Work, bust. Treat dispenser, treating. And since I'm always on this, unlimited mobile.
Wi-Fi and your first line of unlimited mobile free for 12 months. Call 833-802-4999 or visit spectrum.com today.
Wendy's is open until midnight or later, so come get that Baconator.
Give me one honk if you want a Baconator.
Yeah, give me two honks if you want Tyler to make it.
Go night mode. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's Baconator.
Stephanie Olmo First Alert Weather, tonight at 11 on NBC4. This is NBC4 News at 6.
And now at 6, sweltering heat, dangerous wildfires, and now air quality concerns. No matter where you are, we're all feeling the impact tonight. We want to thank you for joining us. I'm Jonathan Gonzalez.
And I'm Annabelle Sedano. Kathy is off. And one of the biggest concerns right now, air quality. And one reason is a rapid fire burning in Riverside County. And the longer the fire burns, the air near Moreno Valley could become unhealthy for sensitive groups. There are also concerns across Southern California due to elevated ozone levels.
As we've seen over the past few days, we've had extremely high levels of ozone or smog, and that tends to form on the hottest days of the year, this being, you know, a fairly hot day. So right now, because of smog, we're seeing levels that are unhealthy, which would be the red air quality index level.
The agency says one of the best tools you can use to track air quality in your neighborhood is their app. Let's check in now with meteorologist Stephanie Olmo for the latest conditions. Stephanie.
Yeah, as we check out the current conditions in terms of the air quality, you find, especially across the interior sections where we're dealing with that extreme heat, we are dealing with unhealthy levels for the sensitive groups. That's the orange that you find here. Right around Santa Clarita and also across portions of the Inland Empire, also getting in some of the red, so unhealthy for much of the population. So we have a mixture of things. We mentioned the ozone. So there's an ozone advisory, especially across those interior sections until late Tuesday. And it's because of the extended period of high temperatures with the heat continuing here that increases that ozone formation, and with the wildfires continuing across Riverside County, there's a smoke advisory as well throughout much of that county. High temperatures, what we saw earlier this afternoon, and reached 104 in San Bernardino, got to 100 degrees over in Riverside earlier today, 110 in Lancaster, likely setting a record there here today. Actually, what to expect as we head into tomorrow. Excessive heat will continue across the area. Onshore flow will persist, so we'll keep those temperatures cooler along the coast. And again, as we continue to this new week, we're still talking about an elevated fire danger. Details in just a bit. For now, back to you guys.
We'll talk to you soon, Stephanie. Thank you. We are still monitoring those four fires burning in Riverside County. Despite triple-digit temperatures today, fire crews did make significant...
Coast has been a popular place to try and cool off this weekend as temperatures inland soared into the triple digits for another day.
And even those who couldn't make it out to the water today had their own ways to beat the heat. Here's NBC4's Bailey Miller.
Southern California beaches are packed as many are escaping from the inland triple digit temperatures.
I'm from LA, so oh my gosh, getting out here today was nice.
It's a hot day, so it's a beautiful day, so we're keeping cool right here.
They're cooling off in the ocean, swimming in the water, and catching some waves in the cool and crisp 66-degree water.
The water feels better than ever with all this heat right now.
And tourists traveling into Manhattan Beach are just happy to feel the fresh ocean.